All right, here we go. Peewee Longway, welcome to Vlad TV.
Hey, man, what's happening, Vlad?
I mean, we got one of the hottest dudes in Atlanta right now. Congrats on everything.
It is what it is.
I mean, you've been putting in some work.
Trying my best, man. You know, I ain't gonna let up. No time soon.
And, you know, when I listen to your songs, it's like, you sound like someone that's been rapping for a long time. Like, it doesn't sound like you just jumped into it and you just bullshit. It sounds like you really have been taking it seriously for a while.
I mean, see, I have been putting my all into it since people started taking a liking into it. But, you know, I did just start. You know what I'm saying? I am fresh to it.
I mean, you've been, what, 4 or 5 years, like, rapping?
Yeah. Strong.
Sounds like it's been longer, man. Congrats.
That crazy, huh?
I mean, some people just naturally, you know, naturally take to it.
I guess I'm one of them, my boy.
Okay, so you grew up on the South Side.
Yeah.
Which zone?
3.
Zone 3.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay. Well, what are the rappers from Zone 3, just so people don't know?
Young Thug.
Okay.
Young Cash Out.
Okay.
Day Day.
Okay, yeah.
Young Rao.
Okay. Y'all got some talent out there.
Yeah, we got Flame coming out at 3, man. Wicked.
That's what's up.
Young Wicked, yeah.
So what was it like growing up in Zone 3 as a kid?
I mean, I wanna say like every other average man, you know what I mean? It wasn't always good, it wasn't always bad. We just took it with each other and ran with it.
Okay. When I look at your music, when I listen to your music and I look at your album covers and stuff like that, I'm seeing a lot of blue. The color blue seems to be very prominent.
It's a nice color, my boy. It's a nice color. It ain't nothing like that.
Now, I assume there's a Crip thing going on?
Nah, just a nice color.
Just a nice color?
Yeah.
No Cripping going
no,
on?
No, nothing. Just no a nice nothing. Color, just the scene. Things in the scenes, man.
Okay. You know, growing up in that type of environment, a lot of people start to hustle early. Like, how old were you when you first started hustling?
I wasn't hustling, man. I was a school guy, man. Going to school, handling my business, man, you know?
You 100% legal? You were good?
Yeah.
Doing everything by the book?
Doing it by the book, man. Make sure it happened.
Okay. You know? And that's the way to answer those types of questions. People get mad at me for asking, but then people answer how they gonna answer. You know what I mean? So when I get that type of answer, I respect that type of answer.
Right.
You know? And for all the future rappers out there, y'all don't have to answer my questions. Y'all can answer like Peewee right. Longway saying that, you know, I ain't affiliated with none of that shit. I don't do none of that shit. I'm just a rapper.
Right.
I respect that. That's what's up. So, I heard you got the name Peewee Longway from a girl.
Yeah, I was trying to get my Instagram thing set up, man. You know what I'm saying? My Twitter thing set up. And I was trying to come up with the name. You know what I'm saying? I blurted out, what I'm going to put? She blurted out Longway.
Okay. But you were Peewee before?
Yeah. Granny gave me that name.
Okay. Why'd you call you Peewee?
I don't know. I get with Granny. You know, I'm a small guy with big thing going. So Peewee, you know, Peewee makes shit just sound big. I like the name Peewee. That's nice.
Okay. I mean, you know, there's some other famous Peewees out there. You know,
That's why I say I run with the name Peewee. I go with that. Yeah.
I mean, I don't know if you ever heard of Peewee Kirkland.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Peewee Kirkland. You know what I'm saying? You know, he's the GOAT.
Yep.
Yeah. You know what I mean? That's the
Absolutely.
GOAT.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's the GOAT. That, you know what I mean? You know, I already know what's going on about Peewee Kirkland. It's in one of them verses, man. I said, neighborhood push on Peewee Kirkland.
It's
in one of my verses already.
Yeah. What was it? A legend in 2 games like Peewee Kirkland.
Yeah, Peewee Kirkland, man. The GOAT.
Okay. So your grandma call you Peewee.
Yeah.
Girl call you Longway. You stuck with it. You got Peewee Longway.
Yeah, we got two of them together.
Now, what made you want to get into rapping?
I'm an urban guy, man. You know what I mean? I'm urban. I'm already urban, so urban is unreal. Well, you know, Thug. I won't say Thug. I won't say Wicked and Duke, man. You know what I mean? Then came along Thug. You know what I'm saying? You know, they had something going on, you know? And, you know, you know, they had a nice sound within themselves, you know, that was different or whatnot. But see, I get me going to the studio with them, and I just wanted to have, they were like, get in there, you know what I'm saying? I jumped in there and had me some fun, man, you know what I mean? I take it that fun, I get a chance to have some fun. And I've been taking it that fun, the folk took it that serious. So that what really made me start getting in. I ain't never been in the music in no type of shape, form, or fashion, you know what I mean? But
okay.
I look at it as having fun, another way for me having fun.
Okay, so Young Thug was rapping before you?
Yeah, hell yeah. Yes, sir.
Okay. So you'd go to the studio with him. He'd be doing his thing. What made you want to just jump in? I mean, would you actually jump into one of those sessions, or were you at home starting to write, you know, get your shit ready?
When it's time, get in there, big boy. That's what he told me, man. He told big boy to get in there. I went in there and tried it. And then, you know, I was like, man, some bullshit, but shit, they didn't let me come out the booth. Made me finish.
Oh, they just kept you in there?
Until I finished, you know what I mean? And I took that serious, like, something that I, you know, as a goal or something I wanted to just accompany and shit. I guess it happened.
Okay, so what was it like hearing your voice on a record for the first time?
Laugh out loud. I mean, funny as a motherfucker, like, shit, but they took a liking into it. It was funny to me, you know what I mean? I still think it's funny, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's still like, I don't want to upset nobody, but shit, it's funny as hell to me.
Okay. Now, from what I understand, you don't write at all. Like, you just go in there and just start rapping.
Yes, sir.
Now, why is that? Why don't you ever write anything down?
Because it's already written in my brain. Like, if I'm going to write it on a piece of paper, I'm going to write it. I'm writing it and I'm going to say it.
Okay. Because there's two, you know, I think when Jay-Z came out and said that he don't write, all these rappers started doing that.
I didn't know when Jay-Z said that. Like, I wasn't familiar with music or none of that when Jay said that.
Okay.
Yeah, I did. This something, yeah.
Okay. Something you know, I've interviewed Jay-Z's producers, you know, like Just Blaze and Young Guru and stuff like that. And what they explained to me is when Jay-Z comes in and does his verse,
right,
you know, from his head, he's worked out the entire verse in his head already. Like, he's not freestyling. He's already worked out the whole verse. You know, he walks around, kind of works it out in his head, and then goes in the booth.
Right.
Do you work out the whole thing in your head first?
Right.
Huh. Right.
Get what, you know what I mean? Like, well, you're going to say what you're going to say on the paper, you know what I mean? You're going to get what you're going to say. Like, I already get, like, the first couple balls in my head, you know what I mean? It's over with from there.
Okay, so you don't work out the whole 16. You work out the first few.
Yeah, look, first look, whatever I'm going to get ready to say, whatever come out my mouth first, that we're going to lead to the whole song.
Okay. So then, like, when do the hooks come in? Afterwards?
I work on your hook either then or I just start it off with a verse. Like, it all get worked out after the song.
Okay. Have you ever tried to write something down?
It ain't going to work.
Didn't work.
Nah, it, like you saying it, like you saying it. You see what I'm saying? Like, instead of just attacking it, like, you ain't gonna attack it the right way. But I can write something down.
So, at what point did the MPA thing come in?
I mean, shit, that's what it started off of.
Okay, so the MPA name, was that around before you started rapping?
Yeah, that's how we came in.
Okay.
How we came in.
Now, are you the founder of MPA?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And MPA stands for?
What it stand for? MPA.
All right. Well, I'm gonna butt in here because you've already addressed this before. you had it on your wall in this one interview. It stands for money, pounds, and ammunition.
Power.
Money, pounds, and ammunition.
Power, or, man. You gotta have
money,
power.
Money,
shoot.
Power, and ammunition.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So money, power, and ammunition. I like hey, it.
It is what I it like is. They talk about the music thing.
How many people are in MPA?
It's a lot of them, man. It's more than 10.
Can you break them down?
It's a lot of them, man. It's a lot, man. I don't want a piece of mine. It's a lot.
Okay. Duke is one of the prominent ones, though.
He was. Duke still is MPA, man. You know, I still look at Duke at MPA. You know, that's the best.
Yeah, no. Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm
one
saying.
Thing about this right here, man. One thing about a brother, man. A brother gonna forever be a brother, man. You know, and whatever side of the fence they go on, man, it's still my brother, man. You know what I mean? I don't look at them no different than they put another name on the front of their name. It's still my brother. So, with that being said, man, yeah, it still is a whole lot of MPAs out there. You know what I'm saying? They okay. still my brother, that's man. What? But we here to talk about Longway. Let's get it.
When do you start doing more shit? Like, after that first song,
yeah,
like,
it's
when
over
you start,
it's time
like,
to keep
serious?
Going. Load me back up, man. I like to hear it back to back, man. Once we locked in, we locked in. It's like a studio session is paid for. So we gonna work these hours, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't got no time to rest, man. We gotta go and lock these hours after hours. Load it back up, let's finish this song. Load it back up, let's do another one, you know what I mean? Like, in the studio session, man, time to work, man. You know what I mean? It'd be a lot of extra pedestrians in there, but it'd be time to work once you spend your money, man.
Right, because at this point, how many mixtapes do you have?
I got more than five.
Hold on, I'm about to look this up. So you got
the season going.
Money, pounds, and ammunition. What? Running around the lobby. Lobby runners. Blue M&M. World War 3D. Felix Brothers. Blue M&M Volume 2. Money MPA 2 Volume 2. MPA Volume 3. Longway Sinatra. So you got a lot of shit. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You got 10 projects.
Yeah, we got a lot more to go, man. They just—I mean, shit, if I would have had like a better situation, or me put my music out, you know what I mean? Like, or I drop more.
Okay, so let's talk about that, because you was, you know, you were working on music, but you were actually the last artist that Gucci signed before he got locked up, right?
Wrong.
Wrong. Okay. Correct me.
No, I was the last artist that we were thinking about going through with that. You know what I mean? Like right now, you know, we still talking about business, you know what I mean? Me and my man, we forever together, man. Like, that's my buddy, man. My brother forever. Like, well, no matter whatever side of the fence I go with, you know what I mean? We're going to forever be 1017 or MPA. You know what I mean? Like, but no, okay. I'm not signed to no one right now.
Okay, so you didn't sign to nobody. Okay, because that's interesting because, you know what I'm talking about. People talk about how you signed to Gucci.
That's my brother, yeah. Yeah, we signed each other forever.
That's what's up. Okay, so how'd you end up meeting Gucci?
Huh?
How'd you end up meeting Gucci?
How did I meet Gucci?
Yeah.
I've been knowing bro for a long time before, you know what I mean? Before we both even thought about we were going to go away. You know, he been cracking. But I've been knowing him before he was cracking right then and there. We've been knowing each other for a long time, man.
But how did you guys actually hook up and start doing music?
He heard I had been going in and out the studio through another friend. And he had sent for me, like, man, tell Long to pull up on me. I pulled up on him, like, man, I heard you had some music going on. You know what I mean? I'm like, shit, you know. I ain't got nothing going on. These boys got something going on. You know, I'm talking about Thug and Duke and Wicked. You know, that's how I started, though, you know? And he was like, shit, I'm just signing you regardless. You know what I mean? I'm going to sign you regardless, but you're going to sign them. You getting signed regardless, just call. You know what I mean? That's how I, well,
if you really think about it, Gucci's one of the greatest A&Rs ever.
Yeah, yeah. Like, he made me literally go on stage and perform James Bond. I ain't know a damn word to it. Like, you just had some stage and perform. Like, you can go in the booth and rap all day long. Get up there and rap. Let me see what you can do in front of them. Yeah, that was brother. Okay. He made another person out of him.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, if you look at all the people that Gucci has been
hands on, you know, yeah, he's the man.
Was fucking with, psh,
yeah, he's the man.
It's crazy.
Yeah, he started. Yeah. He if he put some shit together, man, he started liking on anything. You can believe he's gonna be the one.
Okay, so you and Gucci are working on music. Y'all talking about signing, but nothing happens.
Yeah.
And then Gucci gets locked up.
I'm the big Gucci man then. Who's gonna run to? You know what I mean? All right, shit, big bro, you gotta stand up, big bro. What do we do now? We sit down, we get our head together, we think. Big bro gone, what big bro want us to do? Gone on to the top, man. That's what we did.
Well, while Gucci was gone, he put out a project called the Felix Brothers.
That's right. And you know, to be honest, that probably be some shit we probably been had, man.
Okay. So, Gucci, from what I understand, Gucci puts out projects without necessarily telling everyone he putting out the project.
I look at it and it was more publicity for us and him too at the same time. It kept all the relevant shit. We didn't know what to do with it.
Right. So the Felix Brothers is you, Gucci, and Young Dolph.
Somewhat, yeah.
Okay. Why the name the Felix Brothers?
I mean, shit. That's a good name.
I'm about to look this shit up. I know there's some sort of reference. It's there's some sort of reference in this that you're not telling me. All right, hold on.
It's a good name, when man.
When I put in Felix Brothers, the first thing to come up is the Tijuana Cartel. That's the first thing to come up. Hold on. Okay, here we go. Okay, now I got it. All right, okay. So it's allegedly a reference to that.
Nah, it's just three guys and three of us.
Just three guys. You're right, because you're not a street guy. You're just a regular rapper.
That's it, my boy.
That's it. Okay. So you're putting out these projects. Well, Gucci putting out these projects while he was locked up. Were you talking to Gucci while he was in jail?
Somewhat. I kept my connections.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then Gucci came out and it was just bananas.
As we thought, right? You thought the same thing? Yeah. I thought the same thing. We both thought we were right. Yeah, bananas.
Well, knowing Gucci for a while, what was it like to see the new Gucci come out? Because number one, he's skinny. He don't do drugs. He don't drink.
I mean, shit, a chain man, you know, a chain. Everybody it's due for a chain. I mean, bro, okay. bro, chain. See, I mean, ain't no sense of coming out. What sense that make to go do the time that you know come out for just going for this and come back at the same person? It don't make no sense.
And absolutely.
Nah, I mean, yeah, he's trying to better yourself. Yeah, he better himself. I mean, it is what it is.
Yeah, I mean, he's been dropping project after project.
Yeah,
I mean,
that is same work ethic. That is same work ethic. You know what I mean? Same work method, same everything. Just, you know, just now it's doing it with a clear mind. Now I can think. Now I know what's going on. You know what I mean? Now this, that, just what I supposed to have been doing. But the same work situation going on.
Well, I remember I interviewed Zaytoven recently.
Yeah.
And I asked him whether Gucci Man is the boogeyman of hip hop.
He is like the boogeyman. It's certain things you can't say around him, or you can't, you know, be a certain way with this guy, or he gonna put it in check and it's gonna make you feel like, man, did he just do that or he just say that? So, you know, and he was an intimidating guy. So
yeah, because he's what, like 6'4" or something?
Yeah,
like that?
Yeah. And it's not just his height, and it's not just his size, it's his aura. If you be around him, you can just feel it.
I mean, it ain't somebody, no, not the boogie man that scam folks off and rah rah. Like the other energy. Yeah, you know, the boogie man got to have a lot of energy, man, to go around and get to scare guys.
Why do you think so many people are scared of Gucci? Like, why does he
it's
have
in
that
they mind, man? It's in their mind, man. You know, it's in their mind, man. You don't never know as a person, man. It's in their mind, man. This is what they always thought, man. You know, sometimes, you know, you got to always think about what you did to make the person feel that way about you or however what happened. You know what I mean? It always a cause and effect, my boy. You know what I mean? Somebody did something to make the boogie man mad. But now, though, man, you know, supposed to be scared on their own, man. That shit be on, it be a mind thing.
Feel you. Now you and Young Thug go way back. Now, yeah. I think I remember in an interview, Gucci said that you're the one who brought Young Thug to Gucci.
Right.
Okay. What was that? What was that meeting like, and how did that go down?
See, that was probably the best meeting of my life, man. You know what I mean? To see my man, see Thug, to go somewhere and really show off his talent, man. You know what I mean? To be the person that he always been wanting to be. So, you know, I mean, that probably was a bad meaning in my life. It kind of changed life for everybody, to be honest with you.
And then when Birdman came in and started fucking with him, it just went bananas.
Mm-hmm. Go to work, time to go to work. Like I said, once again, that man get a chance to show his talent around people who need to see it.
Yep. And Young Thug's gone through the roof since then.
Yeah, it's over with. I finally got his own outfit now, man. Much respect, man. You know what I'm saying? Dedicated and determined. Much respect, my boy.
And the two of you just sound real good together. Like when y'all work together, you could tell like the synergy between both of y'all.
Yeah, that it gonna be another type of energy, man. Cause it gonna be a whole another energy. Right? It gonna be another vibe. Yeah, you right.
I was watching a Noisy special with you with Vice. And there was one part in particular that everyone was talking about. And that was when you came out the car and a pint of lean broke on a cop's shoes.
What the hell you got going on? We on Vlad TV, man. We talking about Vlad, man. Next time I ride around with you, man, I'm seeing all that one pop out the car when I'm jump out the car with you, man. Let me see. Why
you... you even wrote a song about it.
I did it, guys.
I think you did.
What song that was?
It was on Mr. Blue Benjamin. You said busting a whole pint on their feet.
Lyric.
Maybe.
Nah, maybe not, man. We don't know how that shit goes. You know, it probably happened.
I like it.
Maybe he did.
I like it.
Maybe
that white dude that I was interviewing y'all.
Yeah, maybe he did.
Maybe the cop, it was his lean and he just dropped it while he was drinking.
Yeah, he dropped it. That was butter shit.
Who the fuck knows, man? It can really go a lot of different directions because you don't actually see the bottle in the video.
You just hear, blah, damn.
You just hear a crash. You hear a crash. So technically,
it butter shit.
It probably wasn't yours.
Yeah, wasn't mine.
It was not. Okay, I see. I'm glad you cleared it up, man, because I think Noisy trying to paint a bad picture of you.
Yeah, man. That wedding night and shit. We don't know who it is. Question mark. Who bottle is it?
Whose bottle was it? Now, gold teeth have been a hip-hop thing for a while, but your golds are actually permanent.
Yeah.
Okay. Like, how old were you when you got your gold teeth?
I've been changed out. They've been different ages, man. But I was young as hell when I had these, man. I was in high school.
Okay, so what, like 16?
Yeah, slugging. Yeah.
So how did it feel when you walked out the, was it, you had to go to the dentist to get it done?
Yeah, to the dentist, yeah. I had just spent some thousands. See, I felt like the man of the year, man. Coming through, you know, I was coming through with the trophy, man. They were trophy back then. I was coming through the dope and the trophy.
Yeah. I mean, do you remember how much it cost?
More than 2,000 back then.
Okay, so you put 2 G's in your mouth,
yeah,
and you showed up to high school with gold teeth.
Yeah, man, I was principal dean list, and I made the dean list out there with the trophy. I made the dean list after that, man.
How long does an operation like that take?
Nah, you be asleep.
Oh, they put you to sleep?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
real, they call it a veneer.
Okay.
You know, they be like,
okay, so they actually had to shave down your teeth.
Right.
Aha. Uh-huh. Okay, so they shaved down your teeth and they put the gold. Is it on the all, like the front and the back?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Slug trophies.
How did it feel to really have the gold in your mouth though? You know, because everyone else got regular teeth. Like, how does that shit feel to have metal in your mouth?
I can't tell you, my boy. Like, you gotta get them and see, man. Go try to get you a couple of them power walls in your mouth.
Paul Wall actually owes me a gold grill, come to think of it.
Yeah, right.
I'm going to hit him up for that shit.
No, I'm up.
All right, so how much more money did you put in your mouth after that initial 2,000?
You know, it go up, man, by the year, man. No bullshit, man. Probably $500 too now.
Okay. Yeah. So what do you think? You got 10,000 right now in your mouth?
Damn near what it is. Probably about 6 or 7.
6 or 7, okay. Yeah. You ever thought of going diamonds?
Hell no, I'm going to let y'all have that. You and that boy Johnny Dang. I'm going to let you and Mr. Dang have that, man.
Okay, I mean, why not diamonds, though?
No, I'm freeze on diamonds. Boy, you know, that. I'm going to stay what I came up doing, man. This is what I got going on. I'm going to be me.
All right. Okay. Now you got interesting tattoos.
No, I ain't got no tattoos. What the hell you talking about, man? What are you saying?
You got a tattoo on your forehead.
Oh yeah, I just did that. Okay. Look at that. Yeah, that's that MPA, man. That's that Eminem, man.
Okay. Now, what exactly is that tattoo of?
Me.
You.
Yeah, I got a picture of me right there.
All right. Now, isn't there a money bag right there?
Yeah.
And that's you.
Yeah.
You a bag of money.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Any more plans for face tattoos, or you done?
Nah, that's it, man. I probably was in Adventureland then. I probably talked to the Eminem man at that time. I ain't gonna tell you what the hell make me go get that. We gonna do it at that land no more. Shit.
Okay. Leave that alone. How long ago was that?
I've been had about 2 years now, man. Y'all guys look closer. I make it invisible, then I make it go away. I make it show again, then I make it come and leave.
Okay. All right, so your song, Master Peewee, that's actually one of my favorite songs that you did.
Oh, man, appreciate
and,
that.
And what I like, I like the Master P reference in it.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, you call yourself Master Peewee, which is, I think, a play off Master P.
Yeah.
And then you say it's the ice cream man, which is...
Definitely Mr.
What Master P used to call himself.
Yeah, right.
Now... What was really like the thought pattern behind doing that?
The beat, actually, you know what I mean? I really only, it came out Casher J beat, man. You know what I mean? It actually came from the beat. You know what I mean, Low Life Black Engineer, and it just went.
Okay. I mean, how big of a Master P fan are you?
I'm definitely a Master P fan, you know what I mean? I came up on all the ladies, you know what I mean? I can't tell you the name of the song, but I can tell you the ingredients to it.
Well, I mean, Mr. Ice Cream Man was one of the big songs he had, and Bout It, Bout It.
Yeah.
That was the big one.
Yeah, definitely he drinking that.
Yep, exactly. Now, Master P was really like one of the innovators.
Master P in that one, man, out the trunk with it. Yeah,
Master P, I mean, and the thing about Master P is, I mean, not only did he have albums that people fuck with, but the company he built with No Limit was
No Limit tank, I mean, for real.
I mean, in fact, you know, I'm going to go ahead and say this. Like, the blueprint for what a lot of rappers do these days, the way they just drop mixtape, I really think that was a Master P blueprint.
It's definitely a pioneer. You know you're a pioneer of this situation. Yeah, we definitely going to tilt our hat to that.
Right, because Master P was the first one, you know, to have a label and drop an album every week.
Right.
So, you know, some albums did well, some albums didn't really do
we're
nothing.
Come
but
back
he kept
at
dropping
again.
Them.
We're gonna have to do it again that week.
Yeah. So when you look at like how people drop their mixtapes, it's really kinda how Master P was dropping his albums back in the day.
Absolutely right about that.
Yeah. Now, Gucci, people were asking him recently about who the better rapper was, him or Peewee Longway. And he said,
Gucci.
He said Peewee Longway.
I say Gucci.
You say Gucci.
I say Gucci all day long.
Okay, so you think Gucci a better rapper than you?
All day long.
But Gucci said you were a better rapper than him.
I get it how we feel. Now you asking that how we feel. That's right there. You know what I mean?
I mean, how did you feel as someone that you looked up to, like a Gucci, to say that he, you know, to give you that type of compliment?
That's my big brother, man. He gonna think that highly of his little bro. You know what I mean? Like, is this something he putting his already stamp on, so he gonna already think that about it. It's just like me, I'm already thinking that about him. There ain't right, no different. I can't feel no different. I feel that way about a lot of these rappers out here. They fine.
Nah, I mean, but I can see where he's coming from, because the way you put your shit together, like, you know, I can see how Gucci would be a fan. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I can too, cause he look at the rap like he going in and do one right now, on the like he ready to put that out to the streets out that gate right now. So yeah, his music, like, I guess he look at me crazy then, cause the way I rap gonna be crazy to him. So I can think of that, but he do the same damn thing.
Now, I heard that LL Cool J actually said that he liked the way he rapped.
That crazy. Fucked me up then, LL. LL fucked me up. You know he fucked me up too, no man. Yeah, he fucked me up.
I mean, you talking about one of the greatest rappers of all time and one of the biggest pioneers in hip-hop.
Man, you know what I'm saying? I ain't lick my lips at a bitch, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? LL.
I mean, if you really think about it, LL's the reason why you got Def Jam. that was Def Jam's first rapper.
Man, LL the shit, right? LL the shit, man. I don't know how the hell he heard a little bit a long way, man. Deep, though. I can't wait to meet Mr. LL, man.
Yeah, I mean... I mean, would you do a song with LL Cool J?
Man, right now, man. I'm saying, I'll let you go through the hard drive right now. We're going to do some scratch or you can go find him something.
I would love I'm ready, man. I think a Peewee Longway LL Cool J track will fuck everybody's heads up.
Hey, man. All right, boy. Whoever can make that helm need to make a helm. I'm ready for you, L.
Now, ASAP Rocky jumped on one of your songs.
That's my buddy, man. The whole ASAP, man. Rest in peace, man. Come on, man. Yams, man. Rest in peace, Yams, man. I love you to death, big brother, man. You know what I'm saying? Got a 8-finger to do a Rest in Peace Yams show for Yams coming up, I think, in January, if I ain't mistaken. Yeah, man. The whole ASAP mob, man. I salute them, man. Them folk believe in Longway for a long way believing in themselves, man. Know what I mean?
Okay, so you actually knew ASAP Yams before he died?
Yes, sir. ASAP Yams finna walk me into the deal, man. Yams finna take my hand and just take me to the deal. Yeah, Yam finna be one of the bigger president one of them record label I had, and I forgot he was going with. Yeah, Yam finna take on a big old position, man. Yam was the man.
Oh, so Yams was getting ready to shop you.
Yeah, Yams had done reached out to all of us out here in Atlanta, man, for a long before we even reached out, like me, Guapo, Pablo, like them boys really lot, like they fuck with us the long way for real. Yams, through Yams.
Yeah, I mean, Yams was a visionary.
Yeah, Yams
saw this shit before it happened.
I'm telling you. Real shit.
Okay. All right, so you hooked up with Yams.
Yeah, he flew us out there and everything to an ASAP party. Yeah, he flew us.
Oh, really? In New York?
Yeah, he flew us to New York and everything.
Really? Like, how many people did he fly out?
Shit, me, my manager Spud, DJ King, man. Three of us. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Had the blue carpet laid out. Yeah, Yam did that.
Okay. So he flew y'all out. And, I mean, was he talking about, like, signing y'all or anything else like that,
man,
to his own shit?
Nah, he wasn't no, like, signing us, like, home was taking us straight to the, like, he was talking about taking us straight to the label. But at that point on, like, he was trying to get us set up to go overseas with the ASAP mall. I'm just getting up, like, introducing her to everybody, you know what I mean? Make, like, because we hadn't did songs and haven't hooked up with Rocky yet. Like, he was just connecting all the pieces to the puzzle, man, that's all.
Dope.
Yeah, Yam was that one.
And then he ended up dying.
Yeah, fuck me up, man. Yam, that's why I say I got to go do that for Yams up there. When they have that shit for Yams, I'm going to be up there in New York.
Okay. So the ASAP Rocky song, I mean, that happened... After Yams died or
nah,
before?
No, that was before.
Ah, okay. Okay. Dope ass song, by the way. Yeah. Y'all two sound good together.
Terminally, yeah. I can't wait. I was just with Rocky for a birthday in LA, man. Yeah, yeah. I still hold on to my connections, man.
Yeah, man. It's sad. Yeah, because it really seemed like Yams was one of those few people that...
Yeah, he was like a little...
You know, I mean, that really, really knew what was about to happen. You know, yeah. saw the talent early.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Another goo-wop.
Yeah. Yeah, actually, yeah. Like a New York goo-wop in a way.
Yeah.
Like, how did you feel when you found out he died?
Fuck me up, man. I ain't gonna lie, I shed a tear for Yam, man. No bullshit. Like, you know, for anybody who felt the way he felt towards, you know what I mean? Shit. He felt the way he felt, like I've been on Yam forever, man. You know what I mean? I just met, bro. And he was already going to a next level with Yams already. So, yeah, it kind of fucked with me, man.
I feel you, man. It was definitely a big loss for hip-hop.
Yeah.
So, right now, you're not signing nobody.
Nah, I'm a free agent.
But I assume you've been talking to labels.
I've been talking to him for real, man. You know how I go.
What's it gonna take for Peewee Longway to sign on that dotted line?
Shit, put it in the right position, man. They gotta come on, just play me in the right position, man. I'm gonna go to work from there, man. It gotta make more, you know, it make more sense. It don't make sense for me and them, man. We're gonna go on the sign. You know what I mean? Once it worked for me and them, then we're gonna sign.
I mean, you saw Young Thug sign.
Oh no, I ain't nothing wrong with signing. It worked for him and them.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Young Thug with 300 worked.
Yeah, it going, yes, it worked. It worked for him and them. They needed that.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying? I agree. I need somebody to need this. You know what I mean? So I'm going to work hard until I work for me and them.
Okay. What do you think is the hardest part about not having a label behind you, having to do it all yourself?
Ooh, that your music, like radio.
Well, I used to be a vice president at SRC Records, right, which is part of Universal. And, you know, we actually was running Vlad TV out of there for like 2 years until they kicked us out. But the one thing that major labels seem to get to have on lock is that they got radio on lock.
You feel?
They got a dude in there that knows every program director at every major radio station.
Ain't gonna make it happen.
When they press that button, brah. You know what I mean? All these stations all around the country start playing your shit 20 times a day.
Right.
You know, and it's hard for an independent artist to do that. Like, for example, like you got like someone like a Chance the Rapper, who's like one of the hottest rappers out right now, but his shit ain't getting played all over the radio.
Right.
Because he's independent. I mean, do you think that not having radio play hurts you as an artist?
I mean, not necessary, but in a way it do. Because I be having some songs that need to go there. So I ain't gonna sit there and talk bad on that. Yeah, it do and then it don't. You know, but sometimes, you know, on the road, I be wanna go to a whole nother venue, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, instead of just, man, I ain't no wrong with me feeding the streets, you know what I mean? But shit, sometimes it's just time to go to another little level sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, a hit song on the radio kind of changes the equation.
You feel me?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, and it seemed like that's the one thing the labels still hold on to.
Yeah, I ain't, you know, it take the artist, man. It don't really just necessarily the radio, man. It take the artist to push himself forward and how far he gonna go. You know, I ain't gonna really need nobody to do nothing else for me, man. I'm gonna put it out there first, man. And show them that I can do it first for you. You feel me? I ain't gonna hold them to that. It's on Long Way, man. Long Way gonna do that, though. I'm gonna handle that.
Feel you.
Yeah, every artist need to know that, though.
Like, what's next for you? Like what's in the plan over the next, you know, 2017?
Oh, we coming out hard, man. We finna drop this MLK song, man. We got a song, Martin Luther King, man. I'm gonna drop me a Martin Luther King song. We got Blue Eminem 3 coming, man. We coming out hard with major video, more visual from Long Way, man. You know what I'm saying? More interviews with Vlad TV, people like you, you know. We're gonna kick pimping this year, man. We're gonna come hard. We're gonna put our all in it, man. No more beating yourself up long. No more nothing that. I can't abuse myself no more for this shit. I'm going harder. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. Well, listen, man, I'm definitely happy for you. You know, definitely happy for your success. You know, and just keep doing your thing, man. As someone that, you know, because, like, you know, we talked about how, you know, you've only been doing this for about 4 or 5 years.
Yeah.
Like, I'd heard that you didn't even envision yourself being a rapper when you were younger.
You feel me? For me to be sitting in front of Vlad TV right now, man, I'm doing pretty good in 5 years, ain't it, my boy? Oh, shit. Yeah.
I mean, as someone that didn't really expect it, what do you think was the biggest surprise once you actually got into it?
Man, fans. Somebody saying that they like what I'm doing. You know what I mean? So I can go on and lead a positive thing. I can go on free the negative. You know what I'm saying? I can go on. Somehow, I really got people that looking up to me now. So I really got to lead by example. I got to lead some shit around here, man. You know what I mean? I can't lead them wrong. So I got to lead my little pack of fans right. You know what I'm saying? I got to go on and lead these folks to be some long ways, some better long ways. Or some, you know, they got to be some shit going on.